I'm Joe Alfano. I'm a senior here at Chatham High School. I participate in AP Art, a proud member of Stage Crew, and after school, I work at a metal fabrication shop. Follow me.
So, I've been doing Stage Crew for about 2.5 years. I started out my sophomore year of high school and kind of worked, you know, at builds, trying to help out as much as possible, whether it be, holding parts together, you know, looking over designs, just being there for, I guess, support. I mean, yes, I was a sophomore, couldn't really do much, but I got to learn about power tools, safety precautions to take, because we're working with, you know, drills, bandsaws, table saws, jigsaws, a lot of saws. But it was a really great experience that I stuck with until my senior year this year. And the one thing that I thought was amazing was meeting so many people, like theater people, crew people. They're all so nice and, I guess, open. And, you know, that's kind of what attracted me to Stage Crew. Yes, you know, there's a whole technical aspect to it, but really, it's. I thought it was more about the people, right? Like the amazing crew members, crewmates, of course the actors.
The real star of every production here. He lets everything's organized backstage because of what he does with his organized sheets.
Hallie is always helpful.
Hallie!
See? Yeah. But it's just been amazing. I've been assistant manager, run crew, and also stage manager this year for the Addams Family, which was amazing. I'm very grateful to John, the head of Stage Crew here at Chatham. And, I really owe a lot to him. Just, you know, working with people, being a leader, a role model to us. It's been just an amazing time. And, you know, when I go off to college, I'm really going to miss a lot of people here. And that's it.
So, I started metalworking when I first met Mr. Hill, which was through mowing lawns. I was a freshman, and, you know, I needed a summer job, so I decided to knock on every door, see who was available. And so I got to work for Mr. Hill, got to know him, and about sophomore year, he's like, "You want to come down and check out the shop?" Yeah, that'd be sweet. So I saw it, totally into it, a really cool place. And so I've been kind of, sophomore year and junior year was kind of on and off, but senior year I've really been focusing in on working after school here. When I first started out, I actually didn't make too many things. I first, did basic things like welding two pieces of metal together, cleaning whatever, cutting whatever, just to get acclimated with some of the tools. And so then later on, I then started to help Mr. Hill with a few of his projects, like retail shelving that he was working on, like these huge glass displays. I helped clean, prime, and basically do all the tedious small things. But now, you know, I did a few art stands for myself, a desk. That's okay. I'm not really too happy about it just because it was one of my first projects. But now I'm working on something that's pretty big and pretty awesome that I can't really disclose at the moment, but will eventually. So, yeah. I guess the reason why I wanted to start metalworking was because of just how awesome it was. Like, I didn't know about machine shops or anything before I met Mr. Hill. And I just thought it was insane to find a shop like this, right in Chatham, kind of down the street. Those who are considering metalworking, I would say, don't rush anything. I was very anxious to, work with all the different types of tools to kind of delve into it. Doing it too quickly kind of makes you lose track of just what everything does. I know my greatest weakness is. A lot of my teachers will back this one up. Starting too many projects at once. I'm the type of person to literally do one thing, get halfway through, and then be like, oh, I really want to do something else. Start another project, and then the cycle continues. What I'm trying to say is, focus on one thing first, feel very comfortable with that, and then move on to the next thing. Don't try and do everything at once, because that's where you can really hurt yourself.